G'day. In today's video, we're going to have a look at one of COSTAR's most powerful sales reporting tools, the Sales Analysis Screen. Now, it's important for a business owner to be able to have their finger on the pulse and know what products they are moving and what services they are performing, along with the gross margin they are reaching on each of those different areas. So the Sales Analysis Screen gives us that ability to view what the sales figures have been on a today, a week, a month, and a yearly basis, along with other pertinent information in regards to those sales and the analysis of those sales. So if we have a bit of a look at the screen, first of all, you can see down on the left-hand side there, we've got a number of sections. These are our product types, and we can see that there's passenger tires, four-wheel drive, light truck and ultra high performance, etc., and that makes up our tire section. We can then go in and it's broken up further into mechanical parts. Any other particular information or any other particular sections that we've created within our sales reporting are all broken up accordingly so that we can get an in-depth analysis of where we're best performing and areas that can require or might require improvement. So the parts, etc., is all totaled up into our products and inventory total. We then have our services and labor total, and then finally our other or special items total as well. From a broad perspective, we can see down the bottom what our grand total is for the day. So 175 and a half units at $6,996.74 in sales. Our gross profit for the day so far is $3,937.69, and the GP is sitting at around about 56.27%. So as I said before, we can then see how we're tracking for the day, the week, the month, or the year. So the total side of things is all well and good, but as the saying goes, the devil's in the detail. So we're able to break down each of these sales even further. So again, where we can see that the total is 175 and a half, for the day, for the tire sales, that equates to 6 passenger tires, 3 ultra high performance, 1 four-wheel drive, and 6 light truck. Now, we're able to see in each of these areas what makes up those totals just simply by double-clicking on that number, and it brings up the individual item number, a description of the item, the quantity, the sales, our cost that it went out at, along with the gross margin of that particular product. So we can see there that while the average of the day is 56.27%, you know we've got a mix there of actual gross margin on each of these products going down as low as 27.89%. So we can then work through exactly what we need to do in order to bump up that gross margin. Okay. So we can also see as we go down into the electrical parts, again, we've got an average gross profit on those different categories as they're laid out there. We'll go into the electrical components. So we can open that up and there we go. And we can see that we got some light bulbs, some ignition coils and spark plugs accordingly, along with the gross margin that's reflected by those products. So some other information that we can get from this particular screen, if we keep scrolling across, we can see our sales mix. So what this is letting us know is as a percentage of our total products and what each of these different categories, what percentage they of sales they make up. So all of our products, passenger tires, make up 12.6% of our total product sales for the day. For the week, it goes to 17.9%. And then for the month, we're looking at 14%. And finally, the entire year is up around the almost 30% for our passenger tires. 10% there as well for ultra high performance and so on and so forth. We then have the total documents that this makes up, or that makes up this number, I should say. Okay, so for the year, total documents was 987 that had passenger tires on it, and the average document value was $270.84. The average units that had passenger tires was 2.3 per document, and the document mix for the total parts was 13%. Again, I've got the ability to drill down on more information simply by clicking on any of these four boxes. So when I open that up, it shows me the list of the documents that contain passenger tires on it. So again, it's broken up by repair order, the invoice date, along with the name of that customer and the quantity, the sales value, the cost and the gross margin percent. And I can see further detail. So when I click on these details, it shows me the passenger tires that were put on that particular repair order. So if I choose another repair order, those details change to what was sold out on that particular one, and we can go back out of there. Other information that the sales analysis tool contains is we're able to go through and show some statistics. So statistics just gives us a brief overview as to account sales versus cash sales. We can see the salesperson and what they've sold out, both in sales, gross margin, and documents as well. And it's exactly the same information that we just analyzed across a different cross section. We've got different sales categories in there. So another way of grouping out products and services. And then we've also got things like the source of business. So where is the business coming from and how that is broken up accordingly. We can also get a direct comparison to last year. So if we click on show last year, we can see the same time, last year we're down 75 units for passenger tires, 288 for our ultra high performance range and so on. Down the bottom here, it gives us our grand totals, which lets us know again, we're down compared to this time last year. So then if we go up the top and untick that show last year, and we've got some other choices there that we can make as well. So we can choose as whether to include any intercompany sales along with any warranty sales and things like that. Another advantage of this sales analysis screen is that we're able to choose what date we want to look at. So if I'm away on holidays or away at a conference, etc., and I want to see how the guys went back at the store last week, I can just click on last week and we click the refresh button, and all of that data that is relevant to that point in time is displayed, and we can do any analysis as required. Other features here is that we're able to export it all either to the screen or directly into Excel. And again, we can use that to do further analysis or data mining. Okay, so that's an overview of the sales analysis screen. We're going to have a bit more of a look at a couple of other things that we can turn on in the settings. So if I go back out of there and down into my settings and order entry options and into our integration 2 menu item, we configure the Microhouse integration providers and then down into our sales analysis. So we've got a number of different settings in here that we can turn on or off, and I'd recommend you do this in conjunction with our support desk as well. Okay, so one of the best ones that we recommend is in manufacturers, you've got the ability to pull up a couple of your major brands so that you get those separated within that sales analysis screen. So in this instance, I'm just going to choose some Cooper tires. If we just scroll down in there, find our Coopers and then our Falcon tires, and we'll also choose some Maxxis as well. So we then can just click our selected only, and we can see that those three manufacturers are pulled out and separated with as the selections there. We've also got the ability to add in monthly budgets, and that gives us then a comparison between our actual sales versus our budget. So we enter it in on a monthly basis, and the number of trading days will depend on the number of days a week you have chosen down the bottom there to flag as open. Okay, so for instance, in July we've got 23 trading days. If I was to enter that in as the monthly budget of $60,000 for our expenses, then it lets us know that the daily expense is $2,608.70. So you can change and have separate budgets for each of the different months. So August you might think is generally a bit of a less expensive month. September, as an example, might be a little bit more. But you've got the ability to set these to be whatever you like. And some people set them as sales targets for the guys rather than its expenses. So you can choose what you want to put in there. So we fill that in for the year. So from there, we've set some budgets and we've also separated out some of our manufacturers. So now when we go back and have a look at our sales analysis screen, those changes take immediate effect, okay? So we can see now if we go over to our week, we can see now our Cooper is separated out from the rest of our passenger tires. Our Maxus and Cooper is separated out for our four-wheel drive. So the idea is when, if we have a look at the year, for instance, we're getting good cross-analysis there of the three major brands that we're supporting, along with a comparison to just all other brands. So we can see, for instance, that we've got, we've sold 45 Coopers, okay, versus the 2,165 of all other brands. We can also see down the bottom by enabling our expenses, how we're traveling for the year. So we can see our sales gross profit for the year is over $663,000. Our estimated expenses is $479,000. And so our estimated profit at this stage, while we're above budget, at $184,000. So that also translates across the month, the week, and we can see that it's red there, letting us know that, hey, we didn't hit budget for the week. We're actually short by $2,002. And then similarly for the day, so far we're traveling at $437 above budget. So that's a brief overview of the sales analysis screen. It is a very powerful tool. It allows our clients to keep their finger on the pulse to make sure that they're aware as to whether the gross profit they're making is suitable and whether they're maximizing the amount of revenue and profit as a result of their sales. Just a side note, obviously any financial decisions should be made from financial reports and not just from sales reports or the sales analysis screen. We hope you found this useful. If you have any questions, just give us a call or submit a support query through our website. To keep a track of upcoming features in COSTAR, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and check us out on Facebook and LinkedIn. Thanks, and we'll see you in the next video installment.